Hi, I'm Pawel, I make games, and I'm gonna show you some simple examples of how to organize your code better. I'm gonna do something like that from time to time as the project gets bigger and bigger. Alright, we have this move to point coroutine, but it doesn't look like something click managers should do. So let's copy that, delete it from this class, and use it in the game manager. Now we are missing some variables, so let's move them too. Let's make them static because we need only one copy of them in the whole game. We are still missing the player, but it's not that bad because now we have a reason to modify this code to work with everything, not only the player. So let's add a new argument to this coroutine and it will be transform my object. Now all we need to do here is to use it instead of the player. Now in click manager we will need to add a player as an argument to this coroutine. It's cool, now we can move whatever we put there, not only the player. And we will also need to access the game manager somehow. That's why we are going to create a new variable of type game manager called game manager, but starting with a lowercase letter. Now we need to grab it somehow, so let's create a new start function, which happens only once at the beginning of this game object's life. And inside let's find a game manager. To do this, let's use find object of type game manager. We are able to do this because we know that game manager will be never deleted. Oh, and there is only one of them, so we don't need to care about which one is grabbed by this function. Otherwise, it would be too risky to use it in a start function just like that. Now we simply paste this game manager name and add a dot before the coroutine name. And that's all of the organization stuff for now. In the next video, we are going to improve picking up items. Have a good day and see you soon!